The US Ambassador, Nikki Haley, brought her Security Council colleagues here with a tight schedule and no media invited, something even the Russian ambassador reluctantly complied with.
We are not allowed to talk.
They were taken by bus to a military base to examine weaponry, which last month Ambassador Haley had unveiled at a news conference. Among the items, fragments of a missile the administration argues was supplied by Iran and fired by the Houthis in Yemen at the Saudi capital Riyadh. The US wants to persuade the Security Council to take tougher action against Iran. Not all on the council are convinced, and many are worried about derailing the 2015 nuclear deal. Ambassadors were under instruction not to talk to the media, with one State Department official rather ineffectively trying to block our camera. But it's clear from the one ambassador who did speak to us, there'll need to be a great deal of further deliberation when they return to New York.
There are various reports. We'll add our impressions today to the reports that there, and the Sanctions Committee will discuss it in New York.
During a wide-ranging discussion at lunch with the ambassadors at the White House, President Trump seemed particularly concerned about Afghanistan.
When we see what they're doing and the atrocities that they're committing and killing their own people, and those people are women and children, many, many women and children that are totally innocent, it is horrible. So there's no talking to the Taliban. We don't want to talk to the Taliban. We're going to finish what we have to finish.
That comment appeared to upend his administration's new strategy in the 17-year-long war. The Security Council, which visited the country earlier this month, had been told the plan was to increase military pressure on the Taliban to force them back to the negotiating table. Some ambassadors privately say they're uncomfortable about this trip and the precedent it set. One told me, "What do we do in a few months' time if we get an invitation from President Putin to go to Moscow?" James Bayes, Al Jazeera at the White House.